afternoon and welcome to this edition of Deacon Daily. Our top story today is about madness that is taking everyone by storm. You guessed it, vertical jumping. Now many people take the jumping process for granted. You'd be surprised at how many people jump incorrectly. The vertical jump is a locomotor skill that involves jumping as high as possible. Before I go on any further, let's cross live to our very enthusiastic jumping correspondent.
Hi Ellen, I'm here at my local primary school, where I've had the opportunity to learn all about vertical jumping. Today, I found out that the vertical jump is actually made up of six components. It's not as easy as just jumping in the air, and it takes time to master the skill. It is recommended that students be introduced to the skill during their foundation or prep year. It is also recommended that at the completion of year three, students will have mastered the introductory components. Alan, did you know that the final stages that include the landing are usually the last ones that are mastered by the child?
No, Emily, I didn't know that. But why is it important for children to learn this fundamental motor skill in the first place?
Very good question. The vertical jump is an important fundamental skill for student learning and movement as it acts as the foundation to the jumps required in many sports, such as basketball, football, netball, gymnastics, volleyball, dancing and aerobics. It is also essential to teach the children the correct technique of the vertical jump in order to help prevent injuries that occur from performing it incorrectly. If students lack competence in foundation motor skills, such as the vertical jump, then they are also at risk of being unable to perform other skills, such as those that require hand-eye coordination, motor development, motor patterns.
So Emily, I know in some sports you need equipment such as helmets and knee pads, but what sort of equipment do you require for vertical jumping?
Well, that's the best thing, Ellen. Students don't actually need any equipment to learn how to jump. All the students need is plenty of space around them, an even surface, and to be able to see their teacher, who should be positioned side on in front of the class. It is important that the teacher be positioned clearly in front of the students so everyone can see them. It is also crucial that the teacher be side on so the class can receive a clear demonstration of how to do each component of the vertical jump. By watching the teacher who is side on to them, students will be able to see how far to bend their knees and how far to have their arms back.
Wow! Jumping sounds really fun! Do you think you'd be able to teach me how to jump correctly?
I sure can! These are the key teaching points for the vertical jump. Eyes forward or facing slightly upwards. Crouch down with the knees. Make sure the arms are behind the body. Thrust upwards with the arms and push off from the ground. Straight legs. Land on the front, balls of the feet, bend knees when landing, and no more than one step taken when landing on the ground. So, the vertical jump should look something like this.
I think I get it now, Emily. Is this correct?
That was a really good attempt. You started with your feet shoulder width apart, and you landed on the balls of your feet with your knees bent. There's only a few things you need to remember to do, such as look forward and have your arms behind you and thrusting them up when you jump. But don't worry too much. Other common errors people make include jumping from standing upright instead of crouching, landing without bending their knees, not having their legs straight when they jump, losing their balance, and taking many steps forward once they land. Would you like to have another go at the vertical jump, Ellen? Just remember, it's important to bend those knees, push those arms high into the air, and land with both feet evenly on the ground.
Alright, I'll give it another go.
You did it! So Ellen, if you were a prep student learning how to jump, your teacher would mainly focus on getting you confident in performing the skill before moving on to games such as helicopter jump, where you would jump over a skipping rope, moving in a circle, flat on the ground. If you were a grade 3 student, however, your teacher would perhaps focus on incorporating this exciting skill into others that are needed to play sports such as volleyball or basketball.
Thank you, Emily. You have certainly overloaded me with this enormous amount of information. If anyone is wanting resources on how to teach the vertical jump skill, places to look include Get Skilled, Get Active, written by the New South Wales Department of Education and Training, the Health Promotion website, and the Fundamental Motor Skills Manual Victoria. Tune in next week for more physical education fun.